Another application problem. This time the ball is thrown upward from a height of 3.5 meters at an initial speed of 50 meters per second. We're neglecting air resistance and solving for the velocity and the height of the ball t seconds after it's thrown. And of course this function that we come up with is only going to be valid before the ball hits the ground. Something to recall is that any object here on the surface of the Earth is subject to the acceleration of gravity, and in meters and seconds, that number is negative 9.8 meters per second squared. Also recall from previous videos that the velocity of a function can be found by integrating the acceleration, and displacement can be found by integrating velocity. We also have these two pieces of information that are given to us. A ball is thrown upward from a height of 3.5 meters. That means that the initial position of our ball is 3.5 meters. Using this d for displacement, that means d of 0 is 3.5. And if our initial velocity is 50 meters per second, that means v of 0 is 50. Okay, let's see what we get. We have that the velocity of our ball is the integral of our acceleration. That's the integral of 9.8. Well, to integrate a constant, you just tack a t on the end. And we get that our velocity function is just negative 9.8t plus some constant. To figure out what that constant is, we can plug in time equals 0, and our velocity function gives us that our initial velocity is c. Of course, the problem tells us that our initial velocity is 50 meters per second, so c equals 50, and our velocity function is then negative 9.8t plus 50. Okay, we can box that up and call that part of the question good. But now we need to find the height function, and the height or the displacement or the position of a particle is given by the integral of a velocity function. So our h of t is just the integral of v of t. We can integrate using the power rule, and we can do a step of simplification here. That gives us a function for height, but it has a constant in it that we can find using our initial condition. Our initial height, we should have called this h of 0, is 3.5 meters. Plugging in 0 for t gives us just c1 from our function, but h of 0 we know has to be 3.5 meters. That gives us a final height function of that right there, and if I didn't miss any parts of the problem, I think that we are finished.